Greetings, I'm Jonathan Spirit, I'm probably not good at building bridges, and welcome to Age of Engineering Supershorts. Happy New Year! Regardless of any perceived bridge building skill, I have built a bridge anyway. I have not asked anyone yet whether this design is good at all, so I'm just kind of hoping. In order to make nice looking fences, I did this with chisels and bits. I don't know if I've ever played with chisels and bits before, but it was actually surprisingly fun. Look, it's a secret. What happens when I press it? I wonder what this could be. Or this. Welcome to my nuclear bunker. Or, my soon-to-be nuclear bunker. It's like nothing ever happened. Actually, this sneaky pressure plate connects to a redstone phantom face, which activates a bunch of phantom breakers that break all this grass and the scaffolds. Item conduits carry the materials to a bunch of phantom placers so that when I press this sneaky pressure plate, suddenly everything is back. I put all the materials I used in here for future reference. My nuclear bunker is complete, and mostly made of factory blocks, with a layer of reinforced stone and an empty layer for wiring. The room has a 15 by 15 interior, with massive hexagonal plating, glowing vents and lamps for the floor, and circuits, fence, and more circuits for the walls, with large steel laboratory blocks for the ceiling. Enderpearl dust is made with enderpearls and a macerator, one wireless charger and one wireless RF transmitter, and a wireless RF battery, tiny inventory system storage, small inventory system storage, and so on, up to extended warehouse. You can't see directly inside this storage, but it's useful for one reason and one reason only. It has the largest number of slots in the game. And for quantum entangled singularities, which don't stack and all have different MBT data, it's practically perfect. Because of this wireless RF battery, I can use this wireless RF transmitter to transfer 80 RF per tick to any block in the world. Which is convenient because I need power way down here for my singularity system. The only block that needs power is the system storage. These exporters will eventually be connected. They export enderpearl dust with a crafting card, tiny TNT with a crafting card, and singularities. This is not a mini chest because this inventory scanner does not respond to mini chests. This green thing is an ender pulsar, which is basically a timer. When it receives a redstone signal, like it's doing right now, it will not pulse. But when there's a singularity in the chest, the inventory scanner will activate, turning off the torch, turning on the timer, which activates every 9 seconds. These little white things act as repeaters. They delay the passage of a redstone signal. So when the ender pulsar activates, after 25 ticks and 35 ticks respectively, these two redstone continents will activate both in the green channel, and they'll pulse this automatic precision dropper twice. This precision dropper, by the way, has a filter on one ender pearl dust and one singularity, while this auto placer has a filter on just one tiny TNT. What's this little setup, you ask? In Super Circuit Maker, redstone signals can switch levers, so when the pulsar ticks, the lever switches on. It activates this quartz resonator, which, after 1 second, switches the lever back and turns the whole system off. But what does the system do? These conduits only extract on a red signal. The redstone signal also deactivates the auto placer while the tiny TNT is being sent in. 20 ticks later, after everything is sent in, the red signal will turn off, so the auto placer will place its tiny TNT. Because the conduits are no longer on, no more tiny TNT will go into this placer. And when the automatic precision dropper is ticked twice, no more singularities or ender dust will go in, preventing an overflow. Finally, the quantum entangled singularities are picked up by a ranged collector that does not respect MBT, and they're pulled into the inventory system storage extended warehouse. Now that I have these singularities, it's time to use them. I'll need 16 quantum rings, 8 flux pearls, and 2 quantum link chambers. The quantum link chamber is set up like so. To link it to another quantum link chamber, all you need to do is put one quantum entangled singularity in each of them. Each chamber can only link to one other chamber, because each time you craft quantum entangled singularities, you get one set of 2 identical singularities. Every other singularity you craft is different. Turns out, this quantum ring needed more power than a wireless energy transmitter could bring it. As you can see by the particles, however, it's working now. Look at that, it's working! I've had some struggles with the storage bus, but I've given a priority of -1000, set it to extract only, and given it a fuzzy card, and partitioned it on quantum entangled singularities. Hopefully, that is enough. That is, enough to keep it from actually inserting, even though I told it specifically not to insert. Security terminal, one wireless receiver, a wireless terminal, and a wireless crafting terminal. I'll put it into the security terminal to link it. Phantom booster, wireless boosters, and an infinity booster card. As much as I would like to put this infinity booster into this wireless crafting terminal and not have to place down this ME wireless access point, I can't open this up without a wireless access point. Now I can, and now I don't have to worry. But I'll leave it here just in case my Infinity Booster card pops out, which it seems to do for Direwolf. This is going to be insanely useful. And that's it for today's episode. Next episode, I'll do actually useful stuff with my nuclear bunker. Like, you know, nuclear stuff. As always, if you have any feedback, I'd love to hear it. I hope you enjoyed!